Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. I'm Prakash, and in this video, I'll show you how to set up a React Native Expo project with Tailwind CSS using NativeWind. Let's get started by creating a new Expo app. I'm using the official CLI here to create a fresh project. I'm now opening project in WebStorm, which is the code editor I'm using for this project. You can use any editor you prefer, but I'll be working inside WebStorm for this demo. Before I start coding, I'm updating the gitignore file to exclude editor-specific folders. This makes sure these files don't get committed to Git, keeping the repository clean and editor independent. Now, I'm installing Prettier to keep the code clean and auto-formatted. This is optional, but recommended. I'm updating the WebStorm settings to apply Prettier automatically on saving files. Once the new app is created, you can start the development server and preview your app using the Expo Go app on your phone. Now let's install NativeWind and the required packages. This will enable Tailwind support in our app. Run this command to generate the Tailwind config file. Now open Tailwind config file and make sure to add the correct file paths under the content section. Also, include the NativeWind preset. Create a new file called global.css and add the Tailwind base, components, and utility imports. Now, we'll update the Babel config so that NativeWind can process Tailwind classes. Next, let's set up Metro to recognize the global CSS file and integrate NativeWind. Create or update the metro.config file like this. We also need to tell Expo to use Metro as the bundler for web. Finally, import the global.css file in your app.tsx or layout file and start using Tailwind classes. Here's a quick test component with Tailwind styling applied. So that's it for setting up a clean React Native Expo boilerplate with NativeWind and Tailwind CSS. Now you can start designing your app using Tailwind utility classes, just like you would in a web project, but inside your mobile app. I'm sharing the full source code on GitHub, and you'll find the link in the description below, along with a detailed blog post. If you found this helpful, don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and drop a comment. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.